compact car cup, and we are using the Renault 5 Turbo, as you can see. Won this in an earlier event. We're going to the compact car stuff. I don't know why I said it again, but still. So, 30k with 7.5k per race. So that is about 50... No, 68,000 credits overall. Which is lovely. Oh, it was a stock spoiler. I was going to say, was it a... never mind. Anyway, let's turn off the assists. We got Seattle to do, which means death. Let us begin. All right, 36 points, so it's relatively easy. Let's see how this puppy does. Hey! Of course, the Renault 5 Turbo, a rally legend and hot hatch legend. It was fast, it was light, and it was nimble thanks to mid-engine layout. There's the VW Lupo. I was always squished in the back seat. Well, those things were tight. They were tiny, weren't they? On the Jazz looking for an overtake. There we go. In the lead now, which means I can pull away relatively quickly. This thing just drives beautifully. By looking at this, my Yaris RS Turbo would be overkill. Kinda. My head was always touched. I was always with my head on the back. Oh god, that must be uncomfortable as hell, dude. Come on now. Bit of a late braking disaster for me there. Look at it. It's even got authentically dangerous yellow headlights because the French love their yellow headlights. Come on. Now he has a much bigger car. Lovely. What's he got? Is it a Volvo? Please stop understeering. Supposed to be a zippy little car. Let's go to TDI. Oh dear. Diesel. A car from 1980 being zippy? Not anymore. It is zippy. It's tiny, it has lots of power, and it is light. Plus, look at it. It's even mid-engine, thanks to the massively flared arches. Clio V6, yeah, it would absolutely kill this lot. Although, not to the same degree as this. This is going to be a long race. Well, a long championship at least. That's what I meant. In Portugal with diesels. Oh god. Why? Have they never heard of petrol? Petrol is the fuel of the gods. The Honda Jazz is outbeating everything else. Petrol fuel is expensive here. Oh, right. That's no good. Because we are cheap, that's why. So it's taxed far more than diesel. Why? Doesn't diesel create more pollutants because it's literally firing soot into the air? But diesel was still cheaper. Hey, Steven, how you doing? Alright, so that was a weird race. It appears that a BMW 120i is beaten by a car driven by 78-year-olds doing 30 in the fast lane. What a picture of my Renault. Zoom into the big yellow headlamps. Damn it, I want to zoom. It is the World Compact Car Championship. You're correct. Anyway, that's our... thumbnail done, and that is the first race complete. Nice. Next race is Sakupa for 5 laps. Oh, Lord. Time to go around in circles for even longer. Come on. There we go, past the BMW, which is for some reason slower than its diesel brother. No, not kidding either. It has less horsepower than its diesel brethren. Past the hideous Mercedes A-Class. Especially with that super cheap grille. Come on, Turbo Powered Express, let's go. Oh God, the Jazz is beating this out on a straight line. Diesel is not dying here. Okay. It appears I'm behind the Yaris by 1.111. There we go, just overtaking them. Yeah. Not the time to rally now. Yaris is now behind me. Which is a shame, yeah. God, this thing handles beautifully. Absolutely no hint of understeer. Beautifully balanced car. God, ugh. Yeah, but carry on accelerating through the tightest hairpin ever, and you will understeer. Look, I'm steamrolling the Yaris. I don't like diesels that much. I really hate diesels. They sound like tractors. These bore power. It has 160 horsepower. It's the same as a Mini Cooper S. At least in this. Not sure about today. I think the new Mini Cooper S is 200 horsepower. See if I can beat 1:10. Go. 1:9.1. Let's see if we can beat 1:09. Now that our tires have warmed up a tad. I don't know why I broke there. Don't say that. I will have to do that very, very later on. Yep, we've beaten 1 minute 9. The race that took us less than 6 minutes. Wonderful. The Jazz and the Yaris are now battling for position. In terms of points, at least. That's another 7.5k for me. Oh, good. Grand Valley East reverse. With VR enabled. Oh, Lord. No. No. That would be the worst time of my life. Oh god, bit of a drift by the Renault. Cold tyres and all. Double trolls at the start. Oh god. Not, no, not again. Not like yesterday's race, hell no. That was awful. Come on, let's get the Yaris. Here we go, about to slipstream the Yaris. Go, overtaken with ease. Drift there, tyres still very cold. Don't know why one of my wheels is warmed up. The left side of my car certainly isn't. Go, this is gonna be a 1 minute 21. Yep. Yeah, tell me about it, which means one side's warm, the other side isn't. Well, it's starting to feel a little bit more stable because one side is warm. Easy on the curbs. Look, those tires are really starting to warm up now. Will I be 1 minute 21? Oh, I beat 1 minute 20, however. Let's beat 1:19. Tad bit of understeer there. No, I ain't beating 1:19 now. In reverse gear. That'll get the other side heated up. Not sure if that'll work, Steve. Attack the cones a little bit. There goes one. There we go. Nice. A bit. Well, there we go. That's the third race done. Oh, it took me bleem forever. Once again, the BMW gets beaten by a Mercedes A-Class. There we are. Time for the fourth race. Don't know how long this one's going to be. Maybe 8 laps, 10 laps, 20 laps. 4 laps around Hong Kong. A place well known for its protests. Or was that the French? I can't tell anymore. Bit of a massive dive bomb. Why did it count me as 4 for a minute? Right, get past this disgusting looking Mercedes. Get the Honda Jazz. Oh, the Jazz is making a move. Oh, it's got the Polo. Bloody hell. The automatic Honda Jazz is trying to outdrag me in a 160 horsepower rally machine. Quit pushing me. He wants a hug. I said CVT. Constant variation transmission. There we go. Yeah, this is going to take me at least 8 minutes. Yes, it is good, sir. Yeah, I got something right. For once in my miserable life. I'm going to go to sleep. See you later. Alright, you take... See you tomorrow. I won't be streaming tomorrow. It's a Monday, and I don't stream Mondays, but I'll see you on Tuesday for some Le Mans action. Take it easy, Romain. No! I won't be doing that till around Christmas. It'll be ILMS for 1 hour. Yeah, don't remind me about the Prius because I'll have to use that later on. Yeah, 24 hours of Le Mans won't be till Christmas, nearly. Well, it'll be close enough to Christmas. It's on the winter solstice. Last night I only slept 7 hours. So did I, and I was knackered. Which is why this is a short stream. Because I want to go to bed earlier so I can actually wake up and not, you know, die in the middle of the day. How's my piss off phone? Leave me alone. Why? How is your buddy still alive? Why am I doing that? Why was I checking my watch while driving? Doesn't make any... Such a stupid idea. They say things like don't text and drive and don't use your phone while driving because it's illegal. What about your smartwatch? That's just how it is to be a trucker. My father's a trucker. He doesn't get 3 hours sleep. He gets at least 7 minimum. Or law's different where you are. By law, one has a right to get 9 hours of sleep for 9 hours of work, but apparently not everyone keeps that. I know in the UK, truck laws, driver laws are very different. A maximum of 8 hours. With at least two breaks in between of two consisting of 1 hour. And you must at least, and you must show your tachograph as well at your works manager. And they must be stamped with the verified hours. Otherwise, you will face having your license revoked. Very strict laws in the UK. Oh, my mother is a trucker as well. No joke about that either. Her dream is to drive a big American bullnose. Or I think she's already done that. I don't know. Whoa, nearly hit the corner of that corner. Wow, 1 minute 42. Damn, that's a good lap. Alright, we're done with Hong Kong. Time for the final race. Oh god, it's twin ring east. Oh lordy. Here we go. Bye, BMW. Bye, Mercedes hideous class. Goodbye, automatic granny machine. And Polo. Now for that Yaris. Here we go, got the Yaris. The CVT Jazz, yeah. I meant Lupo. Listen, I'm knackered, okay? Plus, this is four laps of just making sure your brain keeps working. My brain doesn't work. It's broken. There's lots of broken parts that have not been repaired yet. Which is why I have broken English. Which is why I speak, at best, broken English. You're not French. I know. I'm broken English. Oh god, sliding. Beautifully held. Like mine's any better and I'm not English. I'm sure yours is a lot better than mine. Will I ever get to the top speed? Probably not on this circuit, at least. Two more laps, and I'm done with this rather unusually long championship. Tires are decently warm now, so lots of grip. To go to the test track and waste your life trying to find that out. I'm not sure if this shape will help, however. It's got a long bonnet and a big hat. What can I say? I mean, I've seen more aerodynamic barrels standing up. Through the hairpin. Nice. But then I have to be Sabine Schmitz, don't I? I don't feel like being her today, or ever. Phone's going off again. I don't know why, it's 10 o'clock. Leave me alone. This thing really is massive overkill, but I think it's mainly to do with its handling. I mean, I'm 20 seconds ahead and it's handling. Let's see what the prize car will be. If it's a Motorwagen, I am going to be beyond annoyed. No spoiling then. And there we are. Took over half an hour, but we finally got there. We won every single race, and we've got plenty of money to spend now. Well, we've had plenty of money to spend since. Right, that's 65,000 credits won. I'm really not sure how to feel about this.